What's up, Klats? Welcome to the Mediterranean Sea. We are on a cargo ship. Last year I sailed across the Atlantic Ocean, starting in Italy, sailing all the way across to my hometown in Miami. It was an incredible journey, and hundreds of thousands of you guys enjoyed watching that series that I made, and so that inspired me to create another. I'm currently on a Grimaldi cargo ship sailing towards Salerno, Italy. Our port in the beginning was Ashdod in Israel, and we've been sailing for about 3 days now. Right now, we're currently passing through the beautiful Greek islands. Yesterday, we had an awesome stop in Cyprus, which was a surprise, and that also makes me want to mention to you that if you're new here and if you're watching this for the first time, what's up? My name's Tal. I make videos about traveling around the world, budget travel tips, all kinds of stuff, but recently I've been getting into cargo ships. I have quite a bit of knowledge on how to get on a cargo ship tips, so make sure you subscribe and turn on notifications if you want to learn more about that, because there's going to be cargo ship videos coming out on this channel in rapid fire succession. We're currently filming a bunch of guides on cargo ships and stuff you should know, things you should do, how to get on a cargo ship, how to book a cargo ship, everything you need to know. It's going to be on this channel, so you make sure you're subscribed. But today's topic is going to be what route you should choose when going on a cargo ship. Where should you go? Because there's options. The world is large and you could take it all by cargo ship if you wanted to. Now I'll tell you what, if you've been watching this channel for a while, you know I'm a little bit ballsy, so I don't mind doing a little bit of stuff that pushes my comfort zone and makes me do stuff that's a little bit crazy. So I would recommend for a beginner, if you are a little bit more on the extreme side and you want to experience something a little bit more nuts, book a longer cargo ship in the beginning. Similar to what I did. The first one I did was 18 days. Started in Italy, ended in Miami. We visited 5 countries and it was an incredible experience. It really blew my mind. It opened my mind to this type of travel. I do highly recommend you do it with a partner if you're gonna do a long one. But this isn't that guide. There will be another guide on what you should do and how you should do it later. I will tell you this, from my knowledge, research, and people that I've met who have done cargo ships, I would say to begin in Europe. Europe is awesome because it opens a door for you before and after you board to be able to travel even more within those other countries in Europe, in the country you're actually leaving from, and then after when you depart. Because Europe is so vast and there's so many different cultures and experiences you could have in Europe, it's cool to be able to start and stop in Europe. And actually, there's a lot of cargo ship lines that only travel within Europe. I would actually totally recommend the ship we're on right now. It's called the Grimaldi Grand Mediterraneo, and the route passes through England, Ireland, the Middle East, parts of Italy, parts of Portugal, and even parts of Northern Europe, I believe, in Denmark and Norway. It's an awesome route. Make sure that you check down below. There will be links to anywhere you want to learn more about cargo ships, my videos on the cargo ships, where you can book them, looking at more routes, but I would totally, totally recommend starting in Europe. First of all, passport requirements for European residents is like super easy because you could pretty much go anywhere. There's like no visas required. And on top of that, the accessibility is just so much easier. I'll say the one downside to it is price. Europe is just more expensive than the rest of the world usually, and so it's a little bit annoying with prices, like saying taxis and stuff. But for example, yesterday when we were in the island of Cyprus, it was very, very cheap. Most of everything was super cheap, but for example, when we're going to Israel, or if we go to Italy, or if we go to Spain, prices can get into the 20s to 30s just to leave on a taxi out of the port. So you should keep that in mind if you want. You might have to bring a hefty wallet of cash with you. I would say if you've already done a cargo ship journey in Europe and you're looking for something more adventurous, look at Asia. Singapore is an amazing stop to be able to get off on a cargo ship. I haven't personally done it yet, but I've heard plenty of stories, and especially the people I was with in a cargo ship last time had an amazing round the world journey in a cargo ship where they actually started in the United States, passed all the way around the world, and came back to the United States. They started that journey in Seattle and it took them through South Korea, it took them through Singapore, Japan, a bunch of the Middle East, and a bunch of Europe. And they said that one of their favorite ports to stop in was Singapore. Singapore is an amazing city, also very expensive, but it opens the door for you to be able to go to the rest of Southeast Asia, whether you want to embark or disembark in that stop. Once again, I think it is important to note in this video, I'll be noting it in every single video, cargo ships should not be a means of travel for you unless you have to use them. You know, unless you have some type of medical disadvantage that you can't take a plane or something's inhibiting you from flying, then use a cargo ship. But a cargo ship is an experience. It's very slow, it's very unpredictable. You really can't know what's gonna happen. So don't come in here with a mindset of this is the route, this is the plan. You have to be flexible when being on one of these. And so let's say, for example, you book a trip from Japan to Singapore, something like that, something along the lines of that, and they decide to stop in China on the way, you have to be open to be able to explore China. Super important note to mention, especially when you're looking at routes. Be open to the idea that your route might actually change in the middle. They might either add or remove stops. You might not be getting off on the place you booked to get off of. So if you want to hit a general area, I would say Southeast Asia is probably the second best place to go. A lot of countries are pretty easy to disembark in. I believe Thailand being one of the top places you should go if you want to take a cargo ship there. And the scenery while going through should be absolutely incredible. I would recommend keeping Africa and the Middle East as probably a back choice, or maybe after you've done a few of these, just because there is a risk of pirates. And it does happen. People think it doesn't happen. It does happen. Pirates attack and sometimes actually take over cargo ships, and it's happened plenty of times through history. I would just say get your bearings first, see if this is something you want, because you don't want to end up stuck on a cargo ship that takes forever and then pirates attack. But then once again, pirates shouldn't scare you in this type of thing, because it happens really rarely. So try to keep an open mind and try to just be happy when you're coming on board and enjoy the wonderful scenery. One of the beautiful things about traveling like this is that it opens your eyes to how awesome and beautiful and large the ocean is. And it really brings you back to the roots of when humans began traveling and crossing the world for shipping and for bringing goods. It's really something amazing. So some of my top recommendations for you guys in Europe would be Spain, Portugal, Italy. There are very big cargo ship companies, including this company Grimaldi, which is actually based in Italy, as well as Germany and the UK, as all amazing ports to begin your journey from. A lot of these ports have routes from all over the world, Italy being one of the top and the UK being one of the top. They can send you pretty much anywhere you want to go, and you could actually probably book trips where you get off on a cargo ship, explore a different country, and then join back on another cargo ship later. Some potential routes for you guys to think is probably the one that I did, which is amazing. You could do a 25-day journey starting in Italy and ending in Mexico. Or if you want to do a round trip, it would be 40 days beginning in Napoli in Italy, in Naples, coming all the way back around via the United States and making it back to Napoli again. That would be an amazing route, but it takes a month and a half, so you should keep that in mind. As well, the route that we're doing right now, starting in Israel and ending in Italy, is amazing. It's a 5-day journey, a little taster of what you should be able to expect when you're doing a cargo ship. Maybe they'll stop in Cyprus like they did as a surprise for you as well. If you haven't seen that vlog, make sure that you watch it. If you want to keep things on the lower end, there are actually routes that only take 2 or 3 days that you can go from Italy to Italy. I believe some routes begin in Salerno and end in Gionna. So you should look into those as well, because those are some short routes, might take a day or two to get across, and it'll just give you a taster and you also stay cheap. Cargo ships are expensive, and we'll get into all of that later in another video as well. So just keep that in mind. The longer your route, the more expensive it will be. So just make sure you choose your route wisely, and it's somewhere that you really want to go and you're really excited about seeing. And then be open to the fact of maybe not seeing that exact place. Cargo ships are a hit and miss, but I mean, check this out. It doesn't get any better than this. If you're looking to experience something a little bit more crazy, I would recommend routes that cross through the North Sea. Stuff that maybe go through from Europe to Canada, or from Canada to the north of the United States, and vice versa, back to Europe, maybe Northern Europe. Places where you can experience big, nasty waves and storms. I would do that in the winter if that's something you want to experience. Cargo ships do go through storms. They're supposed to avoid them with their weather trackers, but sometimes they don't. So if you want to experience something crazy like that, I definitely recommend it going up there. It might be something that I might want to do in the future as well. At the end of the day, part of being on here is experiencing what these people experience when they work here. So it is cool to put yourself in those shoes. Some people will call you crazy, but I'll still love you for it, because I get it. If you're looking for wildlife, I've heard the Indian Ocean routes and the Pacific Ocean are some of the best places to see whales, dolphins. Make sure you're exploring every angle of your ship possible to try to see as many angles as you can, as much as possible. During times of sunset and sunrise, I heard, is the best time to see dolphins, and just midday is the best time to see whales. But once again, when you're sailing across the ocean, there is no chances of any of it happening. You can never know. It's really unpredictable. But just to increase your chances, make sure that you use that information to try to navigate and find. Also, a route I would highly recommend is any route that passes through the Straits of Gibraltar. This is something I got to experience last year, and it was incredible, mind-blowing. Being able to be docked between the continents of Europe and Africa and clearly seeing them from the ship is something unbelievable. It's something I totally recommend to anyone. If you can, and you can find a route that stops in the town of Algeciras, which is a port town in Spain, you can actually take a route and take the day to go to Gibraltar if they stop there and you have enough time. The Rock of Gibraltar is something incredible and is one of the top locations for you. And it is very, very cool to be able to come into it via the ocean rather than flying in. And then if you go through the Straits of Gibraltar into the ocean, experience how rocky it is and the craziness of entering the Atlantic Ocean via another sea, it is one of the top things you should be able to see as a human being. So that's your boy Tal and his recommendations of locales that you should visit if you're on a cargo ship, just to get your brain juices flowing a little bit, to think of maybe different locations that you might want to go if you want to embark on one of this. I really hope that I'm helping people promote this means of travel and getting on here. I think it's cool. I think you should come here with a respectful mind and an open mind, and you should watch my other videos on it so you can learn even more, because I think I'm one of the only people on YouTube that's going into this much detail about how it is to travel on one of these. So make sure that you share this video with your friends. If you guys are crazy enough to take one of these journeys together, maybe get your ideas going, share it with a friend, maybe talk to me in the comments, maybe I can even pitch more ideas to you. I'm always learning new things about this, and you should always be learning new things about this as well if you're subscribed to this channel. So we might go on more cargo ship journeys in the future. Make sure that you leave me a big like if you did enjoy this video. And you have to check my other videos on cargo ships below or in the cards on the screen. That's a promise. You have to. If you made it this far, you gotta watch my other videos on it. And I'll see you guys next time I make another cargo ship video. I love you a long, long time. Make sure that you're subscribed, and I'll see you next time.